Someone asked if I could make a video showing how to use ChatGPT to write a scientific review article. One problem with using ChatGPT to summarize the research on a particular scientific topic is that the chatbot may not provide accurate citations of peer-reviewed papers or may even completely make up sources. In this video, I examine whether it is possible to use ChatGPT to summarize published research papers and some of the pitfalls involved. I use the GPT 3.5 version, which is free, and the one most likely used by students who cannot afford the $20 per month to access GPT 4. At the end of the video, I'll suggest an alternative free AI tool for summarizing scientific research. As I've discussed in previous videos, ChatGPT and similar tools such as Google's Bard have a problem with providing citations for the source of their output. In some cases, the chatbot simply makes them up. For example, I ask, how will climate change affect mangrove forests, and to provide at least 5 citations in APA style. I also requested that the chatbot not reference websites in an effort to avoid secondary sources such as Wikipedia. ChatGPT responded by saying it does not have access to proprietary publishers and cannot provide an answer without referencing websites. It then proceeded to craft an answer based on general knowledge about the topic up to the September 2021 knowledge cutoff. As you can see, ChatGPT lists 5 known effects of climate change, such as rising sea levels and changes in storm frequency and intensity. Each item contains a citation that supposedly supports the statement. Let's take a look and see if they are legitimate. The first one is about sea level rise and references Gilman et al. 2008. Looking at the reference list, we find the title and journal information. Checking the journal, we see that there is a paper published by these authors in 2008 and that its main finding is that the greatest threat of climate change on these coastal forests is sea level rise. The next effect relates to precipitation patterns and references Alonghi 2008. That paper also exists and focuses on climate change effects on mangroves. However, it doesn't seem to have any in-depth information about precipitation. The next item is about increased frequency and intensity of storms and lists Yu et al. As authors. A Google search shows no paper by that exact name. The closest one is this paper by a different set of authors. Yu's profile on ResearchGate shows that she studies mangroves, but this particular paper is not listed. So ChatGPT clearly made up this reference. The next item is about global temperature changes and references one of my papers. The citation information is correct, but the paper is not about temperature effects on mangroves. The fifth item is about ocean acidification and cites Lovelock et al. 2007. However, the paper is not about ocean acidification, as you see from the title. Also, the year, journal article number, and volume are incorrect. So out of 5 citations provided, only 1 correctly referenced a published paper that provided information on the stated topic. This is problematic, especially for writing a review paper that requires accurate and in-depth accounting of the relevant literature. An alternative AI tool for writing scientific literature reviews is Elicit. It can find papers on a topic, extract key points from individual articles, and summarize that information. Start by asking a question. Here I've asked, how will climate change affect mangrove forests? Elicit finds papers using the Semantic Scholar database and provides a list of relevant papers. Elicit reads the abstract of each paper and generates a summary focused on answering the question posed. It also provides a one-sentence summary of each abstract. Elicit additionally looks at articles cited by each paper and papers that later cite that paper. Click on a reference to see more information. It shows the paper's full abstract along with Elicit's one-sentence summary. Below that is a list of outcomes measured in the study. This is a review paper, so the main topics covered are listed. Also listed are some of the limitations of the study or information not provided in the paper. You can also ask a specific question about the paper. Clicking on the Semantic Scholar or DOI button will take you to the source URL. There you can confirm the citation detail. It's also possible to apply filters to look for a particular type of study, such as randomized control trials or reviews. There are limitations, however. Elicit uses language models which may make mistakes in summarizing papers. The creators say that Elicit may miss the nuance of a paper or misunderstand what a number refers to. But because Elicit provides the abstract along with the summary, a user can easily double-check the provided summary against what is actually written in the abstract. They estimate that Elicit is currently 80 to 90% accurate in its response. Elicit's output is only good as the papers it is based on. It is up to the user to assess the quality of the research being reviewed. This requires reading the paper and evaluating the rigor of the methods and the interpretation of the results. The creators say that Elicit summarizes the findings of a bad study just like it summarizes the findings of a good study. You can read more about Elicit and try it out at elicit.org. To sum up, ChatGPT cannot write your scientific review paper. Currently, it seems only able to provide a generic summary of a topic, lacking the in-depth evaluation of research and synthesis required in writing a review paper. It may provide legitimate-sounding citations that are inaccurate or non-existent, making it nearly impossible to be confident in the output provided on a topic. This may change in the future as AI tools are improved. For now, AI tools such as Elicit may be better at helping summarize the literature on a scientific topic. Thanks for watching, and please like this video if you found it helpful.